Hello and welcome to the session. I am Asha and I am going to help you with the following problem which says, in figure 9.16, P is a point in the interior of a parallelogram ABCD. Show that, first, area of APB plus area of BCD is equal to half area of ABCD. Second is area of APD plus area of PBC is equal to area of APB plus area of BCD. We are also given a hint that through P, draw a line parallel to AB. So let this be the line which is drawn parallel to AB such that it intersects AD at a point E and BC at a point F. So we are given a point P in the interior of parallelogram ABCD. And first we have to show that area of APB plus area of PCD is equal to half area of ABCD. Since we are given that ABCD is a parallelogram, so this implies AB is parallel to CD, and also by construction we have drawn EF parallel to AB. So this implies that EF is also parallel to CD, since if two lines are parallel to the same given line, then they are parallel to each other, and here the line CD and EF are parallel to the same line AB, so they both are parallel to each other. Now first let us learn a simple property which says, if a triangle and a parallelogram are on the same base and between the same parallel lines, then area of triangle is equal to half the area of parallelogram. So this implies that area of APB is equal to half area of AEFB. Since the triangle APB and AEFB, which is a parallelogram, since EF is parallel to AB and AE is parallel to BF, are on the same base AB and between the same parallel lines AB and EF, so the area of triangle will be half the area of parallelogram. Let this be equation number 1. Similarly, area of DPC is equal to half area of DEFC. Let this be equation number 2. Now on adding 1 and 2, on the left hand side we have area of APB plus area of DPC, and on the right hand side we have, taking half common, area of AEFB plus area of DEFC. Now the sum of areas of these two parallelograms is equal to the area of ABCD. So we have half area of A, B, C, D. Thus, we have proved the first part, which is area of APB plus area of DPC is equal to half area of ABCD. So, this completes the first part. Now, next we have to prove that area of APD plus area of PBC is equal to area of APB plus area of PCD. Now let us draw a line through P which is parallel to BC, which is our construction. Draw GH parallel to BC. Now since ABCD is a parallelogram, so this implies AD is parallel to BC, since opposite sides of a parallelogram are equal, and also since BC is parallel to GH, so this implies that AD is parallel to GH. Now, by using the above property, which says if a triangle and a parallelogram are on the same base and between the same parallel lines, then area of triangle is equal to half area of parallelogram. Therefore, we can say that area of triangle APD is equal to half area of parallelogram AGHD. Now, AGHD is a parallelogram since we are given that AB is parallel to DC, since ABCD is a parallelogram. So, this implies AG is parallel to DH, and also by construction, we have AD parallel to GH. Just now we have proved. And in a quadrilateral, if opposite sides are parallel, then it is a parallelogram. So, AGHD is a parallelogram. Thus, we can apply the property. Similarly, applying the property on triangle BPC and parallelogram HCBG, we have area of BPC is equal to half area of HCBG. So let this be equation number 3 and this be equation number 4. Now on adding equation 3 and 4, on the left hand side we have area of APD plus area of BPC. This is equal to half, taking common, and right hand side we have area of AGHD plus area of HCBG. This can further be written as half area of ABCD, since the sum of parallelograms AGHD and GBCH is equal to ABCD. And thus the area of these two parallelograms is equal to the area of ABCD. So we have area of APD plus area of PBC is equal to half area of ABCD. Let this be equation number 5. Now in the first part we proved that area of APB plus area of PCD is equal to half area of ABCD. And now since the right hand side of both these equations are equal, so the left hand sides are also equal, thus we have area of APD plus area of PBC is equal to area of APB plus area of PCD. So this is the second part we have to prove. So this completes the second part. Take care and bye for now.